Hey, it's June 25th, 2014. I'm Reginald, also known as Demcad. First in political news, 76-year-old senator from Mississippi, Cochran, actually survived a primary challenge from a Tea Party candidate. Now, it was really close, and apparently this guy received a lot of help from Democrats, even some African-American voters who I don't think are going to be voting for him in November. Maybe this was some type of strategy to help the Democratic Party win that seat by getting rid of a candidate that a lot of people thought was actually conservative. They call this guy, affectionately, if you want to say it, a rhino. Okay, basically a Republican in name only. Two questions. One, at this point, does it matter if the Republicans take back the Senate? I mean, does it really matter at this point? I mean, what are they actually going to do? That's the real key. When I look at these elections, what is the actual plan? They don't have a real economic policy. They're not really economically conservative. That's why they focus so much on these social issues. They focus on gay marriage. They focus on abortion, all other stuff, when in reality, they have no real plan for the economic problems this country faces, because they don't have the balls to really take on any type of fiscal responsibility and do what really needs to be done. Okay, and in the Democratic Party, there's not even a truly liberal party either. They're both corporatist parties. I mean, but anyway, all you have to do is look at their actions. But anyway, why would you want to be 76 years old and spending your golden years in Washington, D.C.? Does that sound strange to you? I mean, if I was 76 years old, the last place I would want to be is in Washington, D.C. Actually, I'm 32 years old, and the last place I want to be is Washington, D.C. I mean, maybe to visit the monuments and stuff like that. But other than that, I wouldn't want to actually live there. It just shows politicians are definitely different types of creatures, to say the least. I'll just leave it at that. In other news, Colorado. Apparently, this guy, Bo Perez, won in a Colorado governor's race. Apparently, he beat out a really tough field with a bunch of people, even a former presidential candidate. So this guy won. At first, when I heard that he received endorsements from Romney, I thought, oh, God, he's probably like really anti-gun and everything. But apparently, he has an A rating from the NRA, so I guess I stand corrected. But either way, what are they actually going to do? All right, this is the news that really grabbed my attention. Remember when I told you guys that the government was reporting that the GDP for the first quarter was down 1%? That means the economy shrank 1%. Well, it turns out, according to the Bureau of Economic Analysis, GDP was actually down 2.9%. 2.9%. Okay, almost three times as much as they originally reported. Almost 3% decrease in GDP, which is very significant. And it's kind of funny watching people in the mainstream media try to spin this as, oh, well, but we think the second and third quarter are just going to be fantastic. Interesting enough, business inventory was actually down. Business investment was down 1.2%. The inventory is down significantly as well. Also, short sales. Housing sales actually dropped a little bit. A lot of these housing inventories are down. What's interesting is that with these short sales, you know, let's say you bought a house for $300,000, right? But then you fell behind on your payments and you owed another $200,000. You only paid off $100,000. You owe $200,000 on it. Well, instead of paying off that $200,000 to the bank, you could short sell it to another person. They can buy it for, let's say, $150,000, and that extra $50,000 could be forgiven by the bank, which is a really good deal if you're involved in that type of short sale, if you're the person doing the buying. Terrible deal if you bought it when it was at its peak. So now people talk about this housing recovery. And look, here's the thing. The pricing for the houses were way too high to begin with. They outpaced real income. What happened in the early part of the 2000s, we had a dot-com bubble burst. We had the middle class income start to shrink when you looked at, when you factor in inflation. That was part of the big problem, but we never really saw housing prices really adjust according to those changes in the actual wages of real average workers. So that was part of the big problem. Okay, the Supreme Court made some pretty cool decisions, some big decisions. First, I think this company by the name of Ariel was told that basically you guys have to shut down because what you're doing is not legal. What they were doing was they offered this service for about $8 or $10. They allowed people to actually watch live TV, stream television shows and other even recorded shows, TV shows basically, without copyright deals. They weren't paying copyright fees or anything like that. So they got shut down by the Supreme Court. But even more important, the Supreme Court has declared that police departments, law enforcenment cannot go into somebody's cell phone without a warrant. just because they arrest somebody doesn't mean that they have permission to just go ahead and go through somebody's phone, which makes absolute sense. This is something that's in contrast with what was normally declared by the lower courts, which was, okay, they arrest you, then they have a right to go through all your stuff. To me, if you can just arrest somebody and then justify that and use that as a justification for searching their phones and everything, then I mean, you can come up with a you don't even have to really prove much of anything to arrest somebody, and you can then use that arrest as justification to getting into their phone and using the information you get from there as saying, okay, now I have a case. I mean, you know, that was one of the concerns I really had with that. So I thought it was really important that something like that was really stopped in its tracks. I'm really happy about it. It was actually a unanimous decision, which was pretty cool, okay? California, they're working on a bill. I think it's Bill 189. They're working on some type of bill that actually make digital money real money. They're going to declare it as lawful money, so to speak, lawful money. And now all they need is their governor to actually sign it. So we'll see if they're going to be taking Bitcoins at the local grocery stores in California anytime soon. Anyway, stopped by the store, got myself some water. You know, you may not like Nestle or whatever brand, but it's something I like to do. Decided to get some meat, some white chicken. Just started just a little bit at a time. Now, it's like when people say, I can't afford to prep. A little bit at a time. You don't have to buy the whole grocery store all in one day. Just a little bit at a time. I went to a grocery store, and this is what I picked up. This, that, not really a whole lot, but a little bit at a time. A little bit at a time. And that's how you prep, okay? Simple things, water. You don't need all the cool gadgets, although I like the cool gadgets, and I'm gonna continue to do reviews on them, especially in the upcoming weeks. But yeah, simple as that. All right, guys, share your thoughts. What do you think is gonna happen this November? Do you think the midterm election is gonna produce anything meaningful? Thanks for watching, thanks for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.